Hello, my friends, and welcome to a new night of streaming. This night, I hope it will be really special because we'll go back in time about 24 years ago, and we'll try a game from the CRT era, as I like to call it. So this game has a bit of story. I mean, the reason why we are trying this tonight. From a long time ago, I wanted to try the Xenoblade Chronicles series. As many of you, I guess, know, this series started on the Wii console, continued on Wii U, and now is on Nintendo Switch. It has a great success, and a few days ago Xenoblade Chronicles 3 was launched. It's again a really good RPGs. He got a lot of good reviews, and my intention was, okay, we'll do this series next. But I was starting to read about the game, the universe, and his origins, let's say, and I found out that this game is related also to the Xenogears series, which started on PlayStation 1 24 years ago. So this is the reason that I've arrived at this game. This playthrough is it's a first playthrough for me. I don't know anything about this game. I know it's an RPG from this PlayStation 1 era, when all the games were around they are like Final Fantasy 7 and this kind of mechanics. But other than that, and the fact that it seems that had a very interesting story, which unfortunately seems to not be finished, but we'll dig up about this during our gameplay, I don't know anything else. I hope it's good, I hope it's enjoyable, I hope it will bring some nostalgia to all of you, and we'll enjoy together this game. I wanted to play, as I always do, on original hardware, but on this game I decided in the end to do emulation, because I wanted to correct some of the very known problems that PlayStation 1 has with 3D graphics. I wanted to make some perspective corrections so that I will not have that textures that are going on zigzag in distance and are jumping on the screen. I don't want to have this, but I don't want to have some crazy enhancements added to this. So we'll play as it's intended on 4:3 ratio, and I hope it will be a good experience, even if it's on emulation. Let's see. I'm using Dark Station for this. Presumably we'll have some achievement also, if you can believe. It's a service that was running for a few years now, and you can log on that service, Retro Games Achievements, and using some emulators, they are connected to this service, and you can have achievements in old games. So guys, now we'll start our stream with this game. I hope you'll remember what this sound. Unfortunately, we have a small problem here. I don't want to see that. Okay, and we are back in track. Okay, let's hope it's a good one. Okay. And we'll see the intro now. I understand it's a really good one and classical. the continent of Ignas, in the northern hemisphere of our Earth. On this, the largest continent, a war has begun raging between two countries for hundreds of years. In the north of the continent lies the Kislev Empire. In the south lies the desert kingdom of Aveh. The war has gone on for so long that the people have forgotten the cause, knowing only the pointless circle of hostility and tragedy. The chronic war obsession was soon to encounter a devastating change. This was due to the ethos, an institution that preserves our old culture. Repairing tools and weapons excavated from the ruins of an ancient civilization. At once, both countries excavated these ruins and had the ethos repair the discoveries in order to increase their military power. The various weapons excavated from the ruins greatly changed the form of warfare. The outcome of the battles between the two countries was no longer determined by man-to-man combat, but by gears, giant humanoid fighting machines that were obtained from deep within the ruins. Eventually, after continuous swings in the state of the war, Kislev gained the upper hand. The major factor behind this lay in the enormous difference in the amount of resources buried within their ruins. But suddenly, a mysterious military force appeared in the continent of Ignas, called Gebler. This force decided to make contact with Aveh. With the assistance of this Gebler military force, Aveh was able to recover from being hopelessly outnumbered to being back on even standing with Kislev. Then, taking further advantage of its newly gained momentum, Aveh started to capture one territory after another from Kislev, showing no indication of slowing down in their invasion campaign. The remote village of Lahan, in the outskirts of Aveh. This is where it all begins.
Huff, damn you! Hiya! Huff, that's one down. What on earth are you? No matter how often I knock you down, you still get up. Fei, stop! You must not fight here. Gah, boy, are you persistent? Half, damn it, how come? Why did it have to come to this? Phew. That about does it. All right, now for a short break. Hello, Fei. You are looking well today. My, how time flies. Why, it has already been 3 years since you came to our village. When they first saw you, brought in all bloody and sunken, to tell you the truth, they didn't think you are going to make it. And that strange masked man who carried you here that day, do you think that maybe he was your real father? Don't you remember anything? Why? They say you had terrible nightmares and constantly called out for your father.
My father. Who is it? Who are you? What, you want me to look after this boy?
Let's try some voices to not be very boring.
But now, you are healthy and strong. And it's all thanks to our village chief, Lee. My, should you be grateful? Let's see, this is better. Better. Not really.
This one? Not really.
Yes. This is not... La. Wow.
This one? No.
This
is better. Not really. Well...
I guess this is the best. What this? This is the best. Let's go with this one.
For... the characters, I don't know, I'm not sure. Maybe you're not with any special voices on this game. I don't have analog movement. I don't know if I can hack this. But it's okay for the moment. You know, Fei, I am sure that our village chief thinks of you as his own grandson. Not having any family for all those years and living on his own for so long. That's why he cares so very dearly about you. Please, never do anything that will break his poor old heart. You promise me that, Feila? Fei, you promise? I don't know. Yo, hi there, Fei. Sorry for us all using your house like this. But we have to talk about the big day tomorrow with the village chief. Yeah, tomorrow, huh? You're waiting with Alice. Now, that is a big day. Yeah, right. But it still hasn't hit me as reality, though. Hey, Timothy, I just want to thank you both, you and Alice. 3 years ago, I woke up in this village without a trace of my memory. I didn't know who I was, where I had been, or what I had been doing up until that day. I couldn't recall a single thing. Despite that, you and Alice sympathize with me and encourage me to go on.
If the two of you hadn't been there for me, I don't know what would have become of me. Timothy, from the bottom of my heart, I thank you. Now, you and Alice had better live happily ever after. Ha! Quittle, will ya? You don't have to go and get all mushy on me. Anyway, to me it feels like I've always been friends with you ever since we were kids. And we will go on being friends forever, right? Of course. Oh yeah, Fei. Could you stop by and check on Alice? I still have stuff to discuss with my old man and the village chief. But I'm sure she'll be glad to have some company. Yeah, sure. I'll do that. Anyway, I'll see you later. Oh, and I'm really looking forward to the ceremony tomorrow. Hello there, Fei. Our Timothy is really lucky boy to be able to marry such a beautiful girl like Alice. I hope you come up with some embarrassing tales to tell in your speech. Oh, it's you, Fei. We are in the middle of discussing Timothy and Alice's wedding arrangements. Hey, why don't you bring a girlfriend or two home once in a while? Just because you live with an old man like me doesn't mean you have to hold back now, you hear? Why, when I was young, as you are, it seemed like every day I would... never mind. Now, we still have important things to discuss, so don't get in the way now. Alice's uncle, I don't know whether to be happy or sad. Tomorrow our little Alice is going to become someone's wife. I know this day would come. This is the worst part of bringing up a little girl. I don't know whether to be happy or sad. Okay. Okay. So there you are. Fei, I have to talk to you about something. Why, hello there, Dan. You're lively today, as you are every day. Dan, don't be so rude. What's this bargaining all? Timothy hears too. Butt out, Timothy. Until you marry my sister, you have nothing to do with me at all. I just have some business here with my friend Fei. So, anyway, Fei, I have something to talk to you about later. What is it, Dan? It sounds serious. Yeah, that's why I can't talk about it here. There's a certain person listening in who could cause us trouble. It's really important. We gotta talk, seriously. One to one, man to man. I'll be hanging around outside, so I'll see you there later, okay? Be seeing ya, Timothy. Take care of yourself until tomorrow. What's up with him? As of tomorrow, I'm going to be that skid brother-in-law. That part isn't going to be no honeymoon. Okay. Can we change camera? I don't know. This is the general store, although they don't have much of a selection. But then again, we are out in the country, so can't complain too much. Oh, we can change camera. Wow, this is cool. Really cool. So, the beginnings of 3D revolution. Lately, my legs have been giving me trouble. It's really getting to me. I would like to go and have Dr. Sitan Uzuki take a look at them and tell me what's wrong. But it's a dreadful curve to climb that mountain path to visit the doctor. It must be a sign of my age. That doctor is weird. Why would anyone want to live up in that mountain peak? He should live closer to the village. Hey, you are good friends with the doctor. Why don't you ask him to move closer to the village? Let's see. Can we enter here? Yes. The general store. Just because Alice is getting married doesn't mean you have to be sad. Fei, when I get a bigger, I'll be your bride. Will you wait for me? Sure. Huh? Sure, I'll wait. Well, you mean it? Then cross your heart. Hope to die. Stick a needle in your eye. It's all said then. Our burning love had been tied by unbreakable bonds. It's a cat there. Meow. I have a lot of cats in my life. And now in games lately. Oh, hi Fei. Welcome. The big day is finally approaching, huh? Alice and Timothy's wedding is tomorrow. Hey, how about getting them a stamina drink of courage and love? What do you think? Come on, you've got to get them a present here. We are the only shop in town, you know. Buy. Maybe I have money. I have 100. Omega Soul restores HP and EP to full. Rose Soul restores EP. Why is this 100 and this is 50? Restores HP. No, I don't want to buy anything. Thanks again. Come by anytime. Later, when I have more money, maybe. Okay. What do we have here? What is here? The Laughing Fox and Piggered Tavern. Drunks welcome. Oh, let's go. Drunks welcome. Have you heard the latest rumors? It's said that in the southern desert of Aveh, there is buried treasure all over the place. There's hundreds of people who are trying to strike it rich by digging everywhere. A single strike could make you totally rich. Young one, be aware, I can see it. But then again, you never can tell how much is the truth. There is a dark and icy wind that blows where you are going. A wind that nurtures grief and resentment, inviting death from which there is no salvation. No one will be able to escape from it, but you, and only you, must eventually face up to that dark wind. Just kidding. I've always wanted to try saying that. Did I scare you? I'm really sorry. In life, if it sounds too good to be true, it usually is. Wah. Oh my, welcome, Fei. You wanna have some fun? I give the best service in Lana, you know? Hey, Ellen, quit teasing the innocent kid. Yeah, I know, it's just a joke, you blockhead. Gee, he's got sharp hearing anyway. Maybe next time, okay, Fei? I'll be waiting. So, if you get through the Black Moon Forest to the south of here, you'll find the Kingdom of Fire, Avech. Instead of just wasting away here in this little mountain village, I should go have some fun in Avech. Beautiful girls, tasty liquor. Why, a gentleman like myself is bound to draw the babes wherever I go. Wouldn't that be good? Grams always makes things out to be easier than they really are. It's actually quite a tremendous feat to get through that Black Moon Forest. All those dangerous beasts and fearsome fire-eating lizards live there. I tell you, it's better if you don't go near that place. I wouldn't need anything else if I could only live together with my family, just the three of us. Why can't can men understand something so simple? Another cat, huh? It's cat, no? Yeah, cat. Okay. And the dog. You got a problem with me? Drinking at midnight? How can I not be drinking, dammit? You got a problem, boy? Drinking won't help matters. Shut up! What would you know? You don't know how I feel. I wouldn't want to know, dammit. No. Wait up, boy. I'll give you this. Take it. What is that? I have no use for it. Don't worry about it. Just take it. Nobody knows. In the depths of the sea, a tear drop, shed by a mermaid. Received a mermaid tear. Okay. I can jump. Cool. Wow, let's see items. It shines like a jewel. Guided shot. Here, we don't have anything. File. Equip. Nothing. Stamina ring. Okay, martial cap. Okay. Martial wear, okay. Weapon we don't have. but we cannot see the equipment, unfortunately. We have too much pretensions for a 24-year-old game. Let's see what else we have in this little village. Now, here it is done. Oh, good, Fei. You're ready to talk? As you know, tomorrow's finally the day of my sister's wedding. So, what I want to talk to you about is exactly that, Alice's marriage. Fei, to be perfectly honest with you, I've always wished you could have been my brother. It's still not too late. You could go steal Alice and run off with her. If you need me to help, I'd be glad to. It may be odd for me to say this, but my sister's beautiful and a good cook. And this is just between you and me, but she's well endowed too. So come on, go for it. Let's do it. All right, then. You've got it. I guess I'll just go sweep Alice away and make a run for it. Really? I knew I liked you. Fei, that's the spirit. But if only it was that easy. It's not like we can change their feelings. And you would need to have love for her too. But I'm not gonna forget this, Fei. You are really willing to go that far to help me. Fei, you're a good guy. Great. What happened to you, little girl? You are stuck in a texture. Hey, don't you run in for me. I'm an old guy. I cannot catch you. Damn it, these kids. Phew. What do we have here? Why, hello, Fei. Are you here to see Alice? Actually, it's customary that we don't let any man in to see the bride today. But you can be an exception. Let's see the bride. You know, you won't come out in one piece if you try and pull anything on the bride. Why, hello, Fei. Have you come to visit our Alice? She's upstairs right now. But doesn't time fly? It has already been 10 years since my brother and his wife passed away. We did our best to raise the two children in their place. But now, as far as Alice is concerned, I can finally say my job is done. I know Timothy will take good care of her from here on. Now all that's left is done. I'm going to have a hard time raising him to adulthood. Hello, Alice. Is that your wedding dress? Oh, Fei, you startled me. Yes, it is. I just finished it. It took more work than I expected. You did a great job there. It'll look wonderful on you, Alice. Congratulations. Thank you. Hey, Alice. Fei. What is it? Oh, nothing. I see. Oh, yes, that's right. Fei, have you seen Dan? Yeah, it's outside, bragging as always.
That kid. I just told him that I had an errand for him to run.
Oh yeah? What kind of errand?
It's for my wedding ceremony tomorrow. I was hoping he would go borrow a camera and some lights from Dr. Uzuki up on the mountain peak. If that's all it is, I'd be glad to do it for you.
Could you?
Oh, but I couldn't possibly... Don't worry, it's no problem. Anyway, it doesn't exactly make me feel comfortable having Dan handle such delicate instruments. What's more, I might have a chance to eat some of Yui's cooking if I go to the doc's place.
That's my fate.
Well, I'll go up there now and get them for you.
Oh, Fei, wait.
Huh? Is there something else you want me to get from Sitan?
No, it's not that.
Fei, have you ever thought about things this way?
If you had only been born in this village, and if we had only known each other earlier on.
Oh, it's nothing. I'm sorry.
Well, I think I had better get going now.
Oh, okay. Be careful on that mountain part. And give my regards to Dr. Uzuki.
Is this fate?
I feel so foolish. Who am I kidding?
Hello, Fei. Tomorrow is Alice and Timothy's big day. Isn't it exciting? I know Alice will make a lovely bride.
I hope a handsome prince comes into my life soon.
Hey, stop pushing.
Oh, it's you, Fei. What do you want?
Finally, at my age, I've become able to live in peace. At this rate, I'll probably live to be 100.
If you say so. What do we have here?
This is the village consultant's house. He can teach you all kinds of things. Before you step outside of our village, it might be wise to stop by here for some advice first.
Okay. Let's see. What is this?
Oh, good, good. You're lucky you came. Just at the right time. If it's about the memory cube, then don't hesitate to ask me. No one knows better than I do.
How about it then? Want to hear me out? This is about probably the save system.
Yeah, okay.
All right, good show. That's the spirit. You're pretty smart for an artist. Now open up those ears and carve every word I say into that tiny brain of yours.
Okay, thank you. I'll begin by explaining how to save your adventure. Normally, you can open up the menu screen by pressing the square button. From there, you can select the file option and simply follow the directions to save. However, when you are in town or in dungeon, you can only save a designated memory cube areas. Without a cube, you cannot save.
Those are the days. To make a long story short. So, what do you think? You understand everything perfectly then. Well, you gotta go. You didn't understand the gee. All right, let me explain once more. Alright, this time, make sure you're listening then. This spinning and bubbling thing here is the memory cube I just spoke about. Fearlessly stand inside of the cube's area and calmly and composedly open the menu screen. From there, you'll be able to save into a memory file as per normal. Especially in dungeons and other like areas, as soon as you see one of those, you should save without hesitation. You never can tell what may happen next. When outside of the world map, you can save anywhere you like, probably. If you don't want to wind and up crying later, make sure you save frequently, okay? This is Squaresoft, no? It's exactly like in Final Fantasy VII. So that's it for my concise summary. You took it all in this time, didn't you? Well, even a two-year-old Dongarian monkey could understand my fantastic explanation 120%, right? I'm such a genius. Alright, now for the explanation fee. It's 28 gold. 28 gold is a bargain, considering you are able to receive such a perfect explanation from the likes of me. So come on, drop the excuses, be a man and pay up. I had no option. He took 28 golds from me. Yes, thank you so much. No receipts given though. Let's try this. Bam, 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 bam. File. Okay. No? Not here? I cannot save, what the fuck? Give me my money back, because I cannot save. Damn. What do I need to do to save? Whatever. We'll have a save state. That's stupid. Did you know that you can spin the world around? Yes, I know. Explore the world by using your own eyes and ears. That is how you make the gains in your life truly your own. If you are lost, then be lost. There's no need to rush, is there? Nor do you have to explore the world using someone else's maps. When it comes to fighting techniques, I tend to be extremely fuzzy. I started to study up on them recently. How about it then? Wanna hear what I have to say? Let's see about abilities. You are pretty scholarly for a young gun. Good, now listen up. That guided shot ability you already have is one of the many mysterious powers related to Aether and Chi. Not everyone has the talent to use such powers. People are each born with differing innate abilities. If that individual does have the gift, increasing in level will give birth to more powerful abilities. I see a lot of potential in you. Here you go. This is an allowance for being such an enthusiastic scholar. Wow! Buy some pencils and books with that, okay? Stick with it, kid. What else you can teach me? Ah, not again. He didn't give me money again, unfortunately. Let's see, death blow skills. Good. Ask away, young gun. As you already know, there are three strength levels for the ordinary attack option. Weak, the square button, strong attack is the triangle button, square, strong attack is the square, and the fierce attack is the X button. Death blow skills are special chains of attacks that first use some weak or strong blows to knock your foe off balance and then end with a fierce blow to some major damage. But first you must master the use of weak, strong and fierce attacks in order to become able to learn such death blow skills. To master these attacks, you should keep trying to do, say, 4 weak blows in a row, or 2 strong blows, or even a fierce blow accompanied by another type of blow. In other words, the way to learn new death blow skills is through the frequent use of various combinations of the 3 basic attacks. So, what you think? Doesn't just make you want to go out there now and start learning those death blow skills as soon as possible? Good day, I'm the village consultant. But to tell you the truth, the village chief knows far more than I do. However, the chief is an awfully busy person, so I have been placed in charge of answering some of the more mundane questions. As a special for this week, we are lecturing on the techniques of martial arts self-defense. Wouldn't you like to learn about it? Oh, good. Let's see. Battle commands. Alright then, allow me to explain the overall battle commands. During the battle, there are 2 groups of commands you can choose from. You can toggle between groups of the left and right directional buttons. The first group includes the most frequently used attack, defense and chi options. The second group contains special commands such as combo, escape and so forth. You fight by skillfully selecting from the 2 groups of options the action that best suits your circumstances. Normally, you should be able to get by with just the first group of options. The item option is in both sets, so you don't have to switch groups to use items. Well, that pretty much wraps it up. Please come back again whenever you need my services. Let's see the defense option. Oh, I see. You wish to inquire about defense. Well, allow me to begin. By choosing defense, you can halve the damage your opponent does to you. You can halve the damage. Fighting is not just about being on the offensive. At times, it pays to hold back. When you find yourself in a pinch, it may be a good idea to leave the attacking up to your other party members and simply choose to defend yourself from enemy attacks. Well, that's about it. Oh, and if you have any other questions, please feel free to stop by anytime now. You hear? Let's see action points. Aha, I knew you are going to ask me about them. Well then, allow me to explain about action points. There are three kinds of attacks: weak, strong and fierce, each using up a set amount of action points when performed. When all your action points are used up, your turn will end. Conversely, as long as you have action points left, you may continue to attack. In other words, action points represent how many attacks you can perform in one turn of combat. In the beginning, you will only start with 3 action points. However, you can, as you increase in level, your action points will increase accordingly. The secret in putting up a good fight lies in how you utilize your action points, what strengths of attacks you use, and in what order you dish them out in... Well, that's it in a nutshell. And I don't hesitate to ask if you have any other queries. Let's see, attack. We go through all of them to don't have any surprises. But it's classic 90s RPGs. My, you are bold. Okay then, allow me to explain to you a little about attacking. I am sure that you already know that there are three types of attacks. We go again. Each of which uses up a different amount of action points. The fierce attack, X button, uses up 3 points in a single blow. Hence, if you have only 3 attack points, all will be used up in one fierce attack. The weak attack, triangle button, will use up 1 point per blow. So with 3 attack points, you can attack the same enemy 3 times in rapid succession. The strong attack, the square button, uses up 2 points per blow. So if you've got 3 attack points, you can combine 1 strong attack with 1 weak attack to total 3 points. Yeah! Is it possible to continually press the X button to keep obliterating enemies in one fierce blow? But you may find out that relying on this will have repercussions later. That's about all I have to say about that, really. Please come back by again when you are in need of advice. So, what should I understand that... combos will be rewarding. We'll get better rewards if we use more combos. That would be a cool mechanic if they implemented it. And we are some years before Oblivion, which had I believe this kind of improvement. When you use a special ability, you improved it. Let's see, combo option. Oh, the combo option, huh? I didn't expect you to ask about it. Well then, allow me to explain the art of the combo. When you use the attack option, there are times when you do not use up all your action points. Such is the case when you eliminate an enemy by using only a fraction of your total points, or when you cancel midway through an attack turn. Action points which don't get used are stored up in an action points counter. When this action point counter stores up a certain amount of points, you will become able to use combos. Combos are rapid series of death blows let loose all at one time, and they tend to be rather ferocious, and if foe that on the receiving end of the combo will likely die. At low experience level, you probably won't be able to do much combo damage, but in time you'll become able to do some devastating combo maneuvers. And that's that. So if you need any other advice, you know where I am. I don't need any. You guy, you have something else? Let's see, skill levels. Did we talk about this? Alright, here you go. More about the death blows and their relation to experience levels. If you want to see how close you are to learning certain death blow skills, go to the menu screen and then to the status screen. From the status screen, you can select skills to view a list of your death blows, with the meters showing the percentage learned so far. If one of the dead blows just doesn't seem to be increasing, then you are probably using the wrong types of attack buttons. In that case, it might be best to try those attacks you normally haven't been using. So experiment with different attack patterns. But remember this, some dead blow skills cannot be obtained until you have reached a certain level of experience. If you have not attained that experience level, then it don't matter even if the death blows meter has reached 100%. In this case, you will have to wait until your level of experience increases before you will be able to learn to use that death blow. And that's about it. If you keep it up in your studies, you are bound to go far. Okay, but how do you save? Let's ask this guy again. Don't tell me, it's about the memory cube, right? Right, dude, I want to save. How about it then? Want to hear me out? Okay. Blah, blah, blah. Yeah, but something escapes me.
I don't get it. Okay, we'll save. Maybe something to do with the configuration. I don't know, or the from the emulation. I will make a save state. Yeah. Anyway, guys, so I guess this was the beginning of this RPG. I don't have yet an opinion regarding the game. I mean, it started a bit slow. We didn't get any battle yet, but you know me, I don't rush into games. I want to understand everything around the game, the history, what the characters are saying there. That's the reason I like to read out in these games which don't have speech, because it's a way it's helping me to not skip parts of the story. So everything you read up, it's better remembered, let's say. Anyway, and now I will need to have some feedback from you guys, of course, to know if this is something that you would like to see on our channel. And for that, of course, I hope you can leave a like, subscribe, and leave a comment, of course, in the channel or in Discord about all this. So, guys, this is it for tonight. We'll see you on the next streams. We have a lot of games ongoing, let's say, and maybe we'll add this one if you like also to this big list of games. Until then, I wish you well, and have a good night, guys. Bye bye.